So one time in Australia, Guru Maharaj asked, he said, "What do you want from me, Jagadatma?" And Jagadatma said, I replied, "I wanted him to train me how to be a real disciple of Srila Prabhupada." Guru Maharaj became very sober and nodded his head and was very pleased. He said, "Now I know why I come here. I came here to do this. So you should come to Bhubaneswar for some time and get some association." That was his very strong desire. And thank you so much, what a wonderful talk. I really felt that Guru Maharaj's presence. He really captured many of the things that he said so nicely. I'd like to ask Mataji, Mother Subhangi, can you come and say something, please? She's a little shy. If we can take the microphone to you, is that okay?
Another from Mahanidhi Swami. Srila Govinda Swami is our eternal well-wisher and friend. He's a bandhu, friend of anyone who wants to be a Braj Vasi, resident of Vrindavan, and who wants to serve Rajarani as a Mantrani, especially in the mood of nourishing and assisting Rajarani in her Vipralamba mood of separation. Everyone in the world should have a friend like Govinda Swami. By hearing his sacred teachings and his tales and reading his realized books, if we hold his hand and follow his teachings, then we will meet him again in Raja and thus renew our friendship with Govinda's love, Raja Pandu. Bhakti Tumaj, he was giving class today and spoke about him, and he said he might be needed in another place for another movement where Srila Prabhupada is calling him to. That was really thinking, because the good devotees are all leaving so early and I'm left here. I think why do they have to leave so early? They could do such good preaching here much better than me. So, but maybe Srila Prabhupada really needs him somewhere else. One of our, Shivaram Swami wrote, one of Govinda Maharaj's missions in ISKCON was to show devotees who at that time were beginning to leave to other Gaudiya Vaishnavas that everything that one needed to become Krishna conscious was actually Prabhupada. He wanted to inspire Srila Prabhupada's disciples to Prabhupada's teaching and to become more and more absorbed in Krishna consciousness. Yeah, I really admired when I was reading his book how he was following Srila Prabhupada and how he was taking his service so sincerely. He would not eat if he has not certain amount of books, certain amount of pages in his book. This was so amazing. Who would do this? We all think in terms of eating, first comes sadhana. No, first comes health. Sadhana, then a service. So that's, but it's actually just lived and just was giving all his life and health. Think just to for the mission of Srila Prabhupada. If we would be all so sincere in his Prabhupada's mission, where would we be already now? Would we, I don't know, unimaginable. Then Pata Sarati Swami wrote, Maharaj sat on a bed and I on a chair, and we spoke about bhakti. The level of conversation was so deep, and I could immediately understand that Govinda Maharaj was not an ordinary Vaishnava. That his level of Krishna consciousness was a lot deeper than I had been used to in my regular association. etwas anderes sagen, die Sonne. Then Niranjan Swami, to come in contact with a pure devotee through any medium is incalculable, good fortune. And therefore, in a very transparent way, Srimad Madhavananda Das is extending that good fortune by revealing the essence of Govinda Maharaj's munificent heart in this wonderful book, and good fortune arises. From the core of my heart, I wish to thank Srimad Madhavananda Das for sharing Govinda Maharaj's association with all of us in this most wonderful way. And Jagataka Maharaj, you want to hear? I could see that Govinda Maharaj had so much knowledge of Shastra. On one hand, he was a renunciant, and on the other hand, he had realized knowledge of the Shastra. Late Govinda Maharaj left this world speaking Krishna Katha in the holy Dharma. He even mentioned Gopura, Alchuru, and then he left his body. Swami, he wrote, Govinda Maharaj wanted to train the preachers. Much later, after I started listening to his tapes, I heard how in New York he gave 3 points regarding why he preached the way he did. One was to show how everything is in Prabhupada's books. A second thing was to train the preachers, and the third point was that he wanted to keep devotees from leaving ISKCON. When I heard him talk like this, I immediately made a strong alliance with him. I thought, oh, this is a genuine servant of Srila Prabhupada. He really has a mission. He has thought about it. Yeah. When he went to the printers in Bhuvaneshwar, he was usually taking the bus, but sometimes he could not make it for the bus. So he would walk these 5 kilometers at his servant house. And he, because it was actually lunchtime, he missed lunchtime, so he would not eat anymore the whole day. Just to get the service was first for him. But our last one, Bhakti Rasamrita Swami, he wrote, equally heart-touching as his teachings is the story of Govinda Swami's life. In a sense, there is no distinction between his life and his teachings. After all, a saintly person teaches through his personal example and his life. His life is teaching. I congratulate Gopalji's publication for bringing out this two-part work in the life and teaching of Srila Gopalji Swami Maharaj. Now, Prochan Acham, if we only preach, it is very empty, very hollow preaching. We have to be a good example. And do what we are telling. If we are talking about simple living, high thinking, we have to live off also simple. That's what he showed, he proved it. And Prabhupada was also tuning in when he came to Bhuvaneshwar. He also wanted to be living in the same simple heart like that. Govinda Maharaj, he died.